Chewbacca.
And he's in the air. He's getting it caught there at mid-on. Yes, that is the first wicket that's gone.
1 wicket for five. 4 balls. No runs. He hasn't had a good series at all. And I'm sure he'll be very, very disappointed for us.
Not coming through. You get underneath it. It goes up in the air. Just as happened there.
Yeah, a lot of bottom hand in that shot. He didn't flow through it at all. And just popped it up to the 30-meter circle. Very simple catch.
So now we just have a look at that again. Bidadi judging the catch to perfection. In total control, he caught it so well.
Oh, Mahanama's going to run out of this hit. He is, he's gone. Well, Mahanama there went for the run. He slipped, and that's the danger of a wet pitch. And so Sri Lanka have now lost their second wicket, and that really is a body blow.
There's a replay there. He's gone down the pitch. Over it goes. He's going to need a longer spike out there on the side today. A good throw. I mean, he had hit the stump, and he hit middle stump. So it's a good piece of fielding. But a little bit unlucky there for the batsman.
A dreadful start to Sri Lanka. And in no time at all, they were in even deeper trouble. First, Aravinda De Silva was caught at mid-off by Prasad off Chauhan for 10, 24 for 3. Then, Tilakaratna holed out to Chambli off Kapil Dev for 7, 28 for 4. We pick up play with Ranatunga and Kalpathy trying to repair the damage. Kalpathy facing Kapil Dev.
Down the pitch in the air, that's safe. Maynard gets to the boundary. Yes, in fact it does, it rolls over the rope. Well, you can see from the picture that he'd already made up his mind that he was going to just couple there to charge. Couple there's not able to adjust his... Goes to the big hit, makes good contact, that's great. 4 runs. That was a magnificent hit. He picked the cap beautifully. There's a fielder at Querleg, deep Querleg and a deep fine leg. Once the game comes at him, French cut, gets the inside edge, there's runs in it, it won't be four. Humbly after it. Well, it could be a run out. It'll be close, not out. Very fortunate then at that throw when it kicked, otherwise he would have been back in the pavilion.
Yes, if it hadn't been a wet outfield, that ball would have skidded through very quickly to the wicketkeeper. But the outfield being very soggy, he looked to come at a very sloppy such kind of speed.
Comes down in the air, but goes off the edge. And good running. Comes back for two. Ball is captain through. He's not afraid to be up there on strike. And up comes the 50 for Sri Lanka.
That's up in the air, and he could be out short, or is it going to be a six? No, he's out short at deep mid-wicket by Chauhan. The hopes, and there it is again.
They try to fling Kumble over mid-wicket, and holds out to the fielder at deep mid-wicket. Afternoon FC, this is a terrific start for India. They've done everything right so far. They've won the toss and picked up the early wicket. And the pattern of this game being quite similar to the first game of the tournament where India lost wicket early on.
64 for 5. That's up in the air and it's going to be at least 2 as Prasad runs around from deep mid on to collect. 2 more. There's a flurry of shots now getting some runs for Sri Lanka. And that could be a run out, and he's gone.
There again, the calling has to be decisive. There was yes and no ball, and as you can see here, he had to hit the stump, which he did, and the batsman's out of his ground.
And India now well and truly in a dominant position. That could be another run out and he's gone.
And they're picking up the ball there. Mid-wicket, short mid-wicket. He had to hit the stump. And with this direct hit, he had the batsman way out of his ground. Sri Lanka now in deep trouble.
that's driven fast, touching Thunderside cover. They're going back for the second. They'll have to hurry, but they are home. Senna with it. There should be another two. Kalpage wants it. Kapil gets to the ball. 81 for 7. It's been very little for the Sri Lanka supporters to
come to see the batsman. Picked up a no ball from Prasad. Coming back to the second running, good running there. Excellent running by the Sri Lankans, and they get an extra delivery too, which is very good delivery. Field for caught behind and he's out. Very good delivery, a quickest delivery just outside off stump there for doing the rest.
Yes, the ball did get a little bit more bounce than what it had been doing earlier. And the Kalpage is extremely good innings coming to an end. Kalpage certainly held the Sri Lankan batting together. He played some good shots.
Nice, straight hit, straight down the ground. Just a couple in it. 94 for 8. Right. Well picked up again. He's bowling. Beautiful delivery. Aimed at middle and leg stump, Dharmasena just looking to give himself a little bit of room and paid the penalty.
What a fine ball there by Prabhakar. He's got the reputation of doing this over and over again, and it's still incredible.
Three more runs were added, takes the sorry Sri Lankan total to 98-9, an extremely disappointing performance. And where would they have been without Kalpage, who hit 39 from 56 balls? Only two other batsmen reached double figures. All five Indian bowlers took wickets. Kapil Dev, possibly the pick of them, but all five bowled exceptionally well. And once they had the Sri Lankans by the scruff of the neck early on, they didn't allow them to recover. Sri Lanka 98-9. And with me in the commentary box is Sunil Gavaskar. Oh, just over Chandana there at square leg. Two runs resulting, but that could so easily have been a catch.
It's a series in which to score 99 runs. So you can afford to have a few dot balls. In fact, you can afford to have 52 dot balls and score
about that. And that's a good stroke. It's going away for four. No one will stop that. So the end of the first over, 6 for no wickets.
Tournament for Sri Lanka.
Pass again to Tendulkar. And there we go, Jimmy Aravinda's underneath it, and he's caught it! Tendulkar is gone, caught by Aravinda de Silva, who does it very well indeed. And that is just the wicket that Sri Lanka wants, and listen to the crowd.
And that was one of the most unbelievable shots that a young man could have played. Unbelievable for the sheer stupidity of it all. He's just zero, he's not yet off the mark. The wicket, he's not been able to gauge whether the wicket is, ball's going to come onto it or not. This is the second ball he played, and he paid the penalty for playing the shot, which was unbecoming of it.
Well, again, Prabhakar. Well, having said that, Prabhakar drives very well on the up through the covers. It's a case for Aravinda, and he just gets there. And they run for 3. A lovely throw by Aravinda, right back over the bay. He's in the air, he's going to caught at mid-off, he is. He's gone, caught there by Jayasuriya at mid-off, and that is the second Indian wicket to go.
And once again, trying to play an over-ambitious shot, exactly what the Sri Lankans want. They have kept it quiet. And waited for the batsman to make the mistake. Prabhakar has just done that into the safe hands of Sanat Jayasuriya. That's the second Indian wicket gone for the team.
Oh, that was an absolute beauty. That went right through Azharuddin and through Dasanayake as well for 4 byes.
But it came in so sharply. And it took off as well, just as it passed the stump. I've hit the team sometimes. The bowler does
hit the shoulder a bit.
Oh, that, he was opening the face, it was a thickish edge, and that, no, it's just been pulled back. Chandana did very well indeed there to save one run, a good throw too.
That's got off a good shot off the back foot, should be four runs. Houston guarding it, just pulls it back, good desperate cricket from Sri Lanka. Lovely shot there from Sidhu. Again, picking off finer on this occasion, at least two in it. Azuna giving chase, gets down there, saves the boundary for two runs. Big hit from Azuddin, that is six. That is a magnificent hit from Azuddin. He picked it up and swamped it over the mid-wicket boundary, and that brings up the half century for India, 53 for two.
Pick of the ball, as you can see here, and going through with the spin, hitting it right over mid on, way back into the center. Great shot.
That's another splendid stroke out, Mazaru. That four runs all the way. Goodness, he hit that well, using his feet and finding it.
Walters into this one there, just bumped it into the vacant mid-on region. The mid-on was around a bit wider.
Easy as I don't know what, isn't it? I mean, just flicking it away, beautifully risky. A good throw, but as I had that second run under control. He's going to be out, he is. Azuddin at last has gone. He didn't get hold of that one.
Yeah, Azuddin just trying to force this one over the mid-wicket. At the top, he just twisted the bat a little bit early, caught it on the inside edge. It was quite an easy catch there to the midfielder. But it was a good innings indeed.
86 for three. He's out, he's gone, that was LBW. And I think really that was no more than Tidu deserves
Orchid Namasinghe
Raidu, who bowled very well.
Yeah, I think it's the old case of third time through. Two balls before, he tried to run himself out. This time, absolutely plum LBW. Good bowling there from the bowler.
88 for four. Got to have special nighttime glasses. Arvin Dirt to Campbell. Oh, he's lobbed that back over the bowler's head, and they're going to get two runs. Good throw, but he's two to win, and here is the silver at the Cambly. And there is one of them. The scores are now level, 98 for four. It's in the air, but it's safe, and that is the winning run. So India have won by six wickets and take the first Singer Trophy. And there are the two non-hat batsmen, Cambly on the right, with the gold necklace, Vidadi, who he just congratulated. And India have won by six wickets. Mohammad Azharuddin's 45 was the cornerstone of the Indian innings and won him the Man of the Match award. He and Sidhu added 71 for the third wicket after Prabhakar and Tendulkar had gone early. And so, Mohammad Azharuddin and India take the Singer World Series. Congratulations to them, and also to Arjuna Ranatunga, the man of the series. I hope you've enjoyed our coverage of the competition. For now, from all of us here in Colombo, it's goodbye.